Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll find us.
Lee?
They'll, track us down. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. We should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
Alright, let's talk to Clementine, see what else she says. Everyone seem okay to you?
Everyone out there seem alright to you?
Yeah. Well, maybe not the sick guy.
Yeah. We'll keep an eye on it.
Yeah.
And there was that thing in the bathroom. It tried to get me.
I know.
But you stopped it.
Yeah, I did.
Can you do that more?
Well, I'm not gonna go looking for them.
I mean, get the dangerous ones.
I'm gonna try.
Good.
Have you heard from Glenn?
Have you heard from Glenn?
Not in a little while.
Alright.
I'm gonna keep looking around.
Okay.
Okay, let's,
It's the remote to my dad's TV. That's what I figured.
And I don't know if you know, but I've already played this game through to the second episode. But I, like I said, I deleted my gaming channel and I'm putting everything up here because I'm lazy. And running different channels is just too much and blah blah blah, so. You know, I'm not a gamer and a hardcore gamer and all that stuff anyway, so.
There's nothing I need in here.
Okay.
First aid kit.
First aid kit, alright. I think that is it. Let's see if we can open that door.
It's locked. We need to track down the keys if we're gonna help Larry. Let's have a look at that finger.
Yep.
Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it.
Alright, and so let's bandage it.
Let's get this cut
to square.
Yes, please.
I think it gives you the option to give her the bandage to do it, but... builds up the chemistry and the trust between the characters. This game has just a ton of heart. I've never seen a game that really brings characters to life like this. Okay, I think we're done. Let me just see if the dialogue has changed. How's your finger?
How's your finger?
It's okay. Thanks for fixing it.
I'm gonna keep looking around.
Okay.
So that's really it. So, we're gonna head out.
Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay. Lee?
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
No, he wasn't.
No, he wasn't.
Oh. Was he bad?
He was.
Figured I might as well be honest with her. Alright, so...
can't let anything happen to Ducky.
It's all melted now, hon.
It's all melted. I don't remember seeing that before. All right, let's talk
to everybody. Hey there. This is Glenn, and I'm kind of in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie or whatever?
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up?
Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, all right?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do.
Somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a jog.
So that gives us a little bit of time.
How's your finger, Clem?
Good. It doesn't hurt so much anymore.
Good.
All right, I'm gonna write that. Anything.
Okay.
Dialogue option. Another energy bar. Let's grab that. Just a couple things I want to do before we head out. One of the things is...
You're a pretty good shot.
Carly has a radio.
You don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
What are you working on?
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look.
There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
Just kind of find us, just know. Look for batteries, but... okay, so we gotta find... I forgot about the batteries. Let's find some batteries. Glenn is just gonna have to wait...
Just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
We'll do our damnedest. Hey, Lee, maybe punching him wasn't such a good idea.
There were worse plans.
Says the guy who didn't get punched in the mouth. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
Duck doing.
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kid.
How's she doing?
Her family is dead. She's good, I think.
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Were you saying, Lee, she spent days surviving on her own?
That's right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They own this place.
They, own this place. They, pulled some bodies out of the office before we got here. They're, gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Cat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they did.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
It happened pretty fast.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves.
We killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happened. We didn't make a choice that killed John. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Try to let it go. I'm sorry to hear your loved one was eaten by the living dead guards.
That's awesome. Here's a little glimpse of his family. There's the battery. Let's go give that to Carly. Fix that radio.
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
And I think she still has a problem with the radio.
Hey, Carly. Is it still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Continues to spread unchecked, the estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full... My producer's telling me we have to get off the air now.
Steve.
WABE wishes you and your loved ones... God bless you all.
Hey there.
You seem to
handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
I'm sorry.
She was an asshole, but, you know.
Yeah. Radio sign-off didn't sound too good. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You don't have to be.
It's traumatic.
I'm sure some people got out. Maybe they're all being rescued. Then again, maybe not.
And let's see. I love that stare he gives her.
That guy saved you?
Yeah. Can you believe it? Those creeps, or ghouls, or whatever the hell they are, they were pulling our van apart, and that guy, Doug, just came to the rescue.
You can never tell who the heroic ones are gonna be, I suppose.
He's kinda cute. In that parent's basement sort of way.
Huh?
Huh? Oh, nothing.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. You're ready to head out until you're ready. I mean, there's a couple things I want to do with Doug first.
How'd you end up here?
We drove up to cover the Cherry Blossom Festival. Real hard-hitting stuff.
Sounds worth it. I better get back to it.
All right, yep. So that's all our dialogue Thanks. Options with her.
Don't mention it. Just remember what I said.
Yeah, I will.
Really dig our character. Let's go talk to Doug.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Yeah, let's have a look around.
Let's go have a look around.
Cool, and we'll keep it down. Don't need to bring him back this way with any unnecessary noises.
Agreed. Jesus.
Nice.
Think I'm gonna be sick.
They just
eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you,
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here.
So we're just gonna take a look around. We really can't advance the storyline at this part. We'll have to come back later.
I can't reach that brick.
We can talk to Doug a little bit.
How'd you end up here?
Well, I moved here to live with my uncle. He does tech stuff and it just made sense.
So you're local. You probably knew the owners of this place.
No, not really. I've only been here a couple months and I spend a lot of time...
On the computer?
No, just doing my own thing. What about you?
I grew up here. Been trying to get home since the day I came back.
Oh, so you probably knew the owners then?
Yeah, I did. Good people.
Right. I don't think he had anything else to say. Do you think we're safe here?
Do you think we're safe here?
Well, I haven't been able to get through this gate so far. And the drugstore's safe enough, I think. Whoever owned it took good care of it. It's well stocked and locks up well.
Alright, so we're gonna, take a look at the TV store.
TVs and electronics.
Try to use the remote on it.
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. Let's just hope the power's still on.
You can just do that?
Well, I memorized all the codes when I was in AV. Let's try.
Memorized all the codes.
Well, fucking Doug.
That
dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's to say it already hasn't?
Alright, so that worked. A little bit.
That got a few of them to take notice.
Not enough.
Maybe if I was playing Slayer or some King Diamond videos, they might find it interesting. So, it's a hard one.
Did you guys try to get in there and get weapons?
I did, but it was too risky. And then a bunch of guys showed up and they tried.
And what happened?
I think they're most of who you see wandering around out there.
Trapped over there. That's actually
Lee's brother. Huh? from around here, huh? Could be anybody, you know? They start rotting and get all chewed up and...
Shut up, Doc. Look at the uniform, though. He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
Somehow prove that he worked here. I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find.
Alright, so we already have the photo. So we're gonna click the X.
That guy over there has the keys.
How can you be sure?
And then show him this damn photo.
That boy in the photo worked here. The keys being on him is as good a bet as we can make.
Yeah, I agree. Just need to figure out how to get out there and get them. You wouldn't need long, right?
Nah, just a few seconds.
Maybe there's a way to distract them and buy you some time.
Doc, you want to get this door open?
About that.
You've got the combo, right?
No.
Padlock.
Did anyone ever have it?
Look, man, there were a lot of those things trying to get in here.
And now we can't get back out onto the street.
We're also party to some egregious fire code violations.
Egregious fire code violations? Excuse me, sir. What if there was a fire? I think endangering the lives of the children. Love the Breakfast Club. Okay, so...
running the show, keeping people on watch, things like that. And her dad...
Yeah, that guy.
He's kind of a dick. Pardon my French.
Alright.
Those things like TV.
Or at least the sound of it. If they were louder, we might be able to clear the street.
Alright, so we're gonna head back inside.
Let's head back inside.
Ready to head out?
You got it. You?
Yeah.
Let's go. Did you see that?
I sure did. Be ready to shoot.
Guys! Oh, man. I'm glad you're here.
Jesus, Glenn.
Right then wasn't so hard.
Can we get out of here before any of these things notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
No way. We gotta go, now.
Listen, I was out here looking for gas, and then, up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her and she started yelling and saying I was bitten. I tried to convince her I wasn't, and that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me, and I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
right we can.
You guys are suicidal over a girl.
I'm saving her, with or without you.
Think about if it was you.
Fine, let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
Side of that car.
We're gonna have to make our way over here to the truck. It's a real fun part of the game. The whole game is fun, but it's a little different. And we want to get that.
Drew some attention. Be careful.
I think I found a pretty damn good way to stop these guys quietly.
Now we just have to get it quietly.
How are you going to kill that one by the car without attracting the others?
Their groaning attracts the others.
So we're gonna go.
We can do something with that car, I bet. For that fella lurking near the front.
There's something I want to... What is it that I want to do? Yeah, this is what I want to do. There's a...
smothering them to death.
That's not really what I have in mind.
And then we're gonna work our way back to the truck. Then we're gonna go over here to the zombie.
Get out your gun.
But the noise.
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
I'm sure.
Was sick.
All right. And we're gonna open the door. Grab the spark plug.
Should hold on to that. Could come in handy.
And then push the car to take care of that zombie down there.
That was awesome.
Back to the truck.
see the spark plug. Also, inside these things turns car windows to tissue paper.
I still don't understand how throwing a porcelain or pieces of porcelain at the window could break it like that.
That could scramble a brain pretty good.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
I'm gonna work my way back over here. I'm gonna take care of that zombie, that walker. Peek out. And we wanna walk over here.
Sure. Dude, where'd your weapon go?
Into that ice pick sized hole.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
Are you two done?
Awesome. All right, now we're gonna do some more.
That should help.
Here's Johnny. Do my little.
Why don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
Okay, we'll be right behind you.
Check. Nicholson impersonation. Here's Johnny.
There. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No.
Please. She's in trouble.
No.
Miss, we're coming in.
Oh, God.
I said stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
What?
I told you, I said go away. I'm bit. But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Glenn.
I don't want that.
Maybe
it's not Chris.
He's all sad about it.
Just leave me. Please go.
Come with us.
Come with us. We'll find you some help.
You have a gun.
So?
Uh-oh.
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me?
Borrow.
I can just, you know, end this, and then there's no problem.
Whoa.
Please. I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
Give it to her.
What? You can't be serious.
Do it.
No.
Look at her, Carly. There's no happy ending to this.
Okay. Fine.
I didn't do this the first playthrough.
Thank you so much. I know how terrible this must be.
We can't watch this. Let's go.
We can't go yet.
What? Why not?
Because somebody needs to pick up the gun. Can't leave it. You two go on.
Okay.
This is kind of new for
you, sure?
This part here.
Yeah.
I'm here with you. Well, God bless you.
God bless you. All right.
God bless you too.
Yeah, we had some close calls, but Glenn is fine, and, well, yeah, we're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for your pickup in the trunk of my car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Quiet. Our friend is still in and out over there. He won't survive any more stress.
The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy.
And that said, that was deep. That whole bar with her wanting to commit suicide, that was like, I don't think I've ever encountered a character in a video game that wanted to kill itself. That's what I love about this game, doesn't pull any punches and it keeps it real. Alright folks, that's gonna be it. Thanks for being patient, those of you who enjoy the series, we're gonna continue on once a week.